Hey, can you be Loba?
Yeah, I was Loba already. I've been playing Loba.
Nice. Is that just a coincidence?
Yeah. I mean, she's really good in this, like, new ranked system.
Yes. Yes. And her ultimate's really fast, too.
Yeah, true.
The new ranked system in Apex Legends Arsenal is a joke. Over on Apex Reddit and Twitter, so many are bashing the Apex devs, telling them how much of a screw up this was. And to be fair, you can't blame the guys bashing the devs, cause honestly, ranked is really weird this season. Some big Apex creator called Energy Sweet even went ahead and grinded to Apex Predator, the highest rank in Apex, without firing a single bullet, like zero damage, zero kills. And he actually made it to Pred just to prove how much of a mess the ranked system is, because it focuses heavily on placement and you get very little reward for kills, and the entry cost per game is pretty low, so it's easier to climb as long as you're at the top 5. I've been playing solo ranked because I have no friends. Please help. And what I noticed is that in the end circles, there's so many Loba players. I'm sure you might have noticed it too. And this made me try out Loba, and I found that she's so good in ranked this season. So here's 5 reasons why you should have a Loba in your team if you want to climb the ranks faster. First of all, from the previous season's updates, support legends were given the ability to craft banners, and this season they made it so that as long as you have a support legend in your squad, anyone in the squad can craft banners. So having a support legend in your team is really important, because it literally gives everyone a new passive, the ability to craft banners, so that when you're in a pinch, only one of you needs to survive and they can bring you back. In my opinion, Loba is the best support legend for this. Lifeline's ultimate alerts everyone of your presence and gives away your position, so does Gibby's ult. It's literally a huge indicator showing your location to everyone in the map. Newcastle has a high skill gap and it takes time to start making those big brain Newcastle plays that you see in those Apex compilations. And the only good thing about Mirage is his invisible res ability, which if you're playing for top 5, there's so little chance to res teammates in the final zone. It's really very crowded. Second, Loba's ultimate is good for quick looting in POIs without wasting time, so you can loot quick and rotate faster. Not just quick looting, but it also helps you get good and hard to find loot, like the hammer point hop up. Late game, her ult is so clutch because everyone and their mom is playing for top 5, so the late games are usually so crowded, and if you run out of ammo while poking, you'll wish you had a Loba in your team. Another thing you can do with Loba's ult is yoink banners from enemies after they craft, because so many people craft banners in ranked. This is really hard to pull off. I mean, it's hard but not impossible. Just when you see the green light on a replicator, that means they're crafting banners, so spam nades so they think a whole team is on them, and usually they run away and leave the banners, giving you a chance to steal them with your ult. I did this last night, but I wasn't recording, so there's no footage, but trust me, it works. Third reason why Loba is an essential pick this season is that she can easily get survival items like heat shields and evac towers, which can be hard to find, especially when you're in desperate need of them. Evac towers are really good rotating tools, which make it so that you don't need to have a Wraith or Valk in your squad for you to make quick rotates and move around the map. Fourth reason why you should pick Loba in ranked is that her bracelet allows for quick repositioning, which can be used both offensively and defensively. Like, if you get a knock, you can push faster and capitalize on the knock, or if your teammates are downed and it's an impossible situation, you can just dip using her bracelet and then craft the banners later. It's really good because it can fit through windows and tiny spaces, and they fixed it so it's not as buggy as it previously was when Loba launched. The fifth and final reason why Loba is a must pick legend in ranked this season is that she's super hot. Loba is so beautiful and you get a placebo performance boost when you pick her, so your shots won't miss, especially if you own her swimsuit skin. Too bad I was on hiatus from Apex when they released the swimsuit skin. Loba is beautiful, but you know what else is beautiful? These hoodies from Otaku House. They are custom-made hoodies which are anime-themed. You just DM them, make the request, they make the hoodie for you, and deliver it to you. Not only hoodies, but sweats and t-shirts are also available for sale. They are of really good quality, and the images can be embroidered or DTF printed. Whatever you want, it's available, so be sure to check out Otaku House. The link to their Instagram is in the video description just below the like button. So thank you, Takwell, for working with me. Thank you all for watching to the end. Be sure to leave the video a thumbs up if you liked watching it. That's the best way to support me, and it motivates me to keep making the videos, knowing my subscribers actually enjoy them. And subscribe if you're not already subbed. I'm trying to get to 2k subs before the year ends, so please please help me get there. And I'll see you in the next one. Have a lovely day.
I just wanna tell you.